Money fetish, yeah, money fetish, yeah, I got fetish. Y'all nigga broke, getting shit on credit.
Hey, Slay Mafia. Today I'm going to show you guys how to do a blunt cut with a long layered bang, okay? The first thing you want to make sure is that the hair is brushed all the way down and make sure that you have shears. A blunt cut is a 0 degree, which means that it's straight down. There's no tension, there's no elevation, none of that. That's why I'm using my comb to make sure I have all the hairs intact. I'm only cutting about half an inch. You can cut more if you would like, but this is just how much I'm cutting because I need this mannequin for school. But as you can see, I don't cut past my second knuckle because you can't hold the hair with tension past your second knuckle because there's space. And I'm using a guide, which means I'm using the hair that I just previously cut and putting it next to the hair that I didn't cut so I can make sure that the cut is going to be the same length all around. So if you don't get what I just said, just pay attention and you'll see. And if the hair is too short and don't reach, do not cut it. If the hair don't reach, don't cut it. Make sure you guys are paying attention with the guide. Now I'm just checking it, holding it straight down, using my comb, and then holding it 90 degrees straight out from the head. So now we're going to go into the bang. I'm just parting my bang area, and then I'm going to pin up all of the extra hair just to make sure that it's out the way. So now we're just gonna cut the hair section by section. We're going to do a 90 degree. This is a 90 degree. You're holding it straight out from the head, and like I said, I'm only cutting about half an inch, but as I go up the hair I will cut more than half of an inch just because I want more layers. And no, I'm not ashy. I was trying out this clay mask on my hand, and I thought I wiped it all off, but obviously I didn't, so please don't mind that. I promise you I'm not ashy. Pay attention to what I'm doing at 90 degrees straight out from the head. And now I'm just going and diagonally trimming it. You don't have to do this part. I just wanted to, just to make sure that the layers is going to lay right. So now I'm just going to pin up the bang part just so it can be out the way so we can get into flat ironing. I'm going to part the back section into two sections just so it won't be a lot of hair I have to pin up, and I could just go section by section. I like cleanliness when I'm working. So while I'm flat ironing, I'm just going to add a little bump to the end just because I like it that way. And I was just checking my cut, as you can see. A little bump, nothing too serious. Please don't mind the people that you see in the background. And I just went ahead and flat ironed it off camera because, I mean, you should, it's not really hard to flat iron. But if you want a video on that, let me know. I got you. Now watch me fly. Now this is how it looks with the little bump. It's cute, it's cute. So now we're gonna get into the bang part. First part is gonna be bumped a little bit straight down, and make sure you pay attention to how I'm flat ironing. Straight, and then turn it. Straight, then turn it. Straight, then turn it. And my camera did turn off halfway through, but now I'm just fixing up this part. And this is how it looks so far. And I just like to put the little piece behind the ear. I just think that's cute. So now I'm gonna use a wide tooth comb. Comb the hair back, bring it to the front, and there you go. Long layers, honey. That is cute. And that is it, and that is all. You can let me know how yours turned out. I like comments, I like feedback, and Slay Mafia out.